you are connected to the third layer of energy. Each one of us are related to the third layer of energy. The man who can access the three layers of energy is an enlightened man. Man who is yet to access is an enlightened man. That's all. Energy darshan means I try to access the third layer energy and try to flood the third layer energy through this body, and all of you will have a glimpse or a touch of that energy. Every one of your Ajna chakra, the third eye, will be touched with that energy, so that all your chakras can be awakened, all your chakras can be energized. This is the real gift which you can receive from an enlightened master or a divine person. You see, whatever you heard from yesterday or whatever you practice meditation, for all those things I am not necessary. You can take it, get it even from a professor. Whatever I spoke to you from yesterday to today, even a professor will speak. I think professors will speak much better than me. A philosopher will speak much better than me. For that, I am not necessary. You can get it just from an ordinary professor, ordinary teacher. Intellectual explanation is not the real gift which you receive from master. Energy is the real gift. Because energy you can't get anywhere else. That is the real gift which you receive from the master. The third layer of energy will be allowed to flood into my being, so that you will have the glimpse of your own divinity or the energy. You see, whatever you heard from yesterday or whatever you practice meditation, for all those things I am not necessary. You can take it, get it even from a professor. Whatever I spoke to you from yesterday to today, even a professor will speak. I think professors will speak much better than me. A philosopher will speak much better than me. For that, I am not necessary. You can get it just from an ordinary professor, ordinary teacher. Intellectual explanation is not the real gift which you receive from master. Energy is the real gift. Because energy you can't get anywhere else. That is the real gift which you receive from the master. The third layer of energy will be allowed to flood into my being, so that you will have the glimpse of your own divinity or the energy. Let me give you the program schedule now. Still we are ahead of schedule. I am actually little early. I come always little late. The Sandhya time. Sandhya is the time to start. We will wait for a few minutes and then we will start. First, we will work on the Sahasrara chakra. There will be a discourse and the meditation on the seventh chakra. Just like other energy centers, this energy center also will have a discourse, and we will work on, there will be meditation to work on the chakra, Sahasrara chakra. After the meditation, there will be kirtan. Kirtan means, understand, singing and dancing the name of the divine is called kirtan. Dancing not for anybody seeing, or not dancing for show. If you dance for somebody else's sake or for show's sake, it is ordinary dancing. Kirtan is dancing for your own sake. It's like your own ecstasy, your own joy, you spread it out. It's like a fish jumping into the ocean of bliss and diving. Allow this kirtan, allow this divine name or singing to penetrate your being. Automatically your being will bubble with joy. and allow that joy to express through your body. That's all. Actually, when you learn some dance, you miss the joy of the whole dance. When you learn some step, you will be concentrated only on the step, not on the joy. If you know Bharatanatyam, means you lost the joy of Bharatanatyam. If you know breakdance, means you lost the joy of breakdance. Whenever you learn the rules, you lose the joy. Whenever it is spontaneous, you enjoy the ecstasy. So allow that joy to penetrate you and let it express through its own way, through your body. That is what I call kirtan. Neither dance for somebody's sake, that he is seeing or he is seeing or she is seeing, or stop dancing because he is seeing or she is seeing. No way care for the other. It is your joy, your expressing. Third eye will be touched. Most of the time people feel a lightning shock or current entering into them. Don't feel frightened. I'm not having any battery or light line, current line with me. It's not a current or shock. It is just a spiritual energy flowing into your being. So don't be frightened. Don't be afraid. It will be just, of course, I'll try. You will not get frightened. It will not be so strong. It will be very, very, actually, it will be strong but very joyful. It will be very strong but it will not be frightening. It will be very relaxing. So don't be afraid. If you receive it with a prayerful mood, without fear, all seven chakras will be penetrated. If you are frightened, if you are afraid, it will stop only in Anahata or Manipuraga. So don't be afraid. Relax so that it can go into you and work in you the spiritual miracles. The spiritual energy can work miracles in you. Allow that to happen. And the main thing, if you want any of your real good wishes to be fulfilled, remember at that moment, because your thoughts will be flooded with energy. There is every possibility of them getting fulfilled. Understand? I am not fulfilling. I am not going to give you any boon. I am not fulfilling. But when the thoughts are flooded with energy, they become alive. They get fulfilled. And for any reason, please don't think any bad for anybody. It will happen. I have seen many people coming and telling me. And even for your own sake, very clearly decide what you are supposed to ask or what you are supposed to think. Because people ask very casually, and when it gets fulfilled, oh, I shouldn't have asked that, Swamiji, I am now in trouble. After that, they repent. Don't do that. Think very clearly. Just have a clear view what you are going to think. Now itself, prepare yourself. You see, if in front of a projector light, if you keep a slide, it will come in reality. You can see that in reality. Just like that, in front of an energy, if you keep a thought, that will become reality. So, understand very clearly, there is every possibility of your thought becoming reality. So be very careful what you ask. Be very careful about what your desire is.